Welcome back to more Darkwood. sorry about the slow uploads, but I've been struggling a bit with mental and physical health issues. But yeah, there's not much you can really do about it. A man grabs my arm and pulls me closer. A strong smell of mushrooms assails my nostrils. The old sack covering his body slides down, revealing his chest covered in hard growths. It is fused with a porous helmet, pulsating to the rhythm of his breath. I'm starting to feel dizzy. Without loosening his grip, the man raises his left arm, bringing his forearm to my face. It's pale as paper and reads, "Do not open the door. Let's stick together." Well, if I don't open the door, I'll never leave this place. I'm sorry, man. So, I guess I could meet him at the underground entrance. Then I have to bring all of my stuff. So I have to bring all of my guns. And I have to bring all of my ammo as well. So hang on a second while I do that. Yeah, forget the lockpick, get the Molotov. I do need to bring some wood and nails. Just purchase a new lantern. I'm going to need that. Let's bring this. already out of room. So what I can do... shovel. Take this. It really sucks because you have to leave all the stuff behind that you've accumulated. But you know what? Oh well. Alright, let's go open the door to the old swamp. If I can make it. Corpses. I don't see the corpses. So, if I'm at the corpses, I must have gone a little bit too far. There's all this stuff to explore here. I would really like to explore this area. But, I would also like to head to the swamp. Nope. There. Right. Ow. Yeah, okay. Just need to figure out how to get in. Okay, I just went too far. Ow. really search anything here. Yeah, I would like to pick up the mushrooms, but even more importantly, I think I need to get to the underground entrance. That's right. Should be straight down this way. Alright, so I'm actually going to see. Let's do this. Okay, whatever. Let's go. If you want to read this. Thank you. So this area is interesting because you encounter some crocodile thing. Switch this one out. A swamp there. I don't know what happens if you ever get caught by it. I've never been caught by it. I don't even know if you could get caught by it. And there's a shiny stone. That we'll see of the other map. All right. So now we cannot go back to where we came from. Here's our generator. We have a little bit of gas, but let's just dump this whole can in here. Or at least part of it. There should be a wood machine somewhere around here. Let's fill this up a little bit. Okay, and then the rest in the compressor, or the generator. So you can go ahead and pause if you want to read this, but basically the whole map has changed. We have some weapons there, and I think we can, this has already been lit up for us, we can put away the mushroom, wardrobe, let's see, I think the wardrobe, nothing in here. So now we can actually just put some stuff away. It's 9:20 a.m., so we don't need to worry about locking up right away. And let's go explore just a little bit. Now I don't have any of my Molotovs. It's okay. We will figure something out. Let's make an antidote just in case. I'm gonna keep the knife here as a backup in case. Yeah, all of this stuff I don't mind losing. Let's cook that one mushroom. Right, so whenever you have a crate that's covered in dark yuckiness, then you have to shine light on it. Do I have light on me right now? Yes, I do. Okay. Basically, we just stand here at the light. And this note will actually tell you shell, thick goo, and light. So that's just your hint. And you can see the gray bar on the bottom disappearing. And now we can examine the crate. So that's all useful stuff. So since we're starting from scratch, we're not gonna have any reputation. Just gonna try to forage for some stuff. Thank you. actually gonna have to drop something. I'm gonna drop this flare. Actually, do I have any flares? Well, I'll put my navigator here. I'm gonna head back up. Let me drag this lamp over. If the poltergeists come and decide to turn off the light, they only turn off one light. Then I usually like to block off one of the windows with the wardrobe. And barricade this. Repair this. And you know what? I'm actually going to take this lamp as well. It would be nice to have some bear traps, but unfortunately I don't have any. What we do have though are these gas tanks. I don't have any room in my inventory. Let me drop off that cloth. I don't think I need that cloth. Things here. This might be useful. Let's just make a chain trap. I mean, something's better than nothing. So, if we have a chain trap, it's going to keep them on a chain. What we can do is, let's put it over. turn on the generator. We don't have a lot of protection for tonight, but we'll see what happens. I think usually the first night is kind of easy. So hopefully it won't be too difficult. Let's turn on this lamp as well. Oh good. We have some supplies here. And there are some more maps from, I think, the military. I'm not really sure if this tells you anything about the current map that you're on, because I think they always look the same. Besides the fact that the maps are always randomly generated. So the first night they will tell you, come back to us, whatever that means. And then he says, soon, I'm close. And I don't really think anything else really happens in the first night, aside from that. But I will wait until the first night is over, just in case. But definitely the enemies in the swamp area are going to be a lot more difficult than the ones in the previous areas. Event. So just want to have your flares ready in case the lights all shut off. So if you're a dog, let's just aim. In case he gets hurt. Or we could just barricade the door again. Wait, let's shoot this guy instead. One of my least favorite enemies. Thank you. Okay, so someone did get caught in the trap, maybe? But anyway, let's turn off the generator. This is our poor friend from the previous map. Liar is on the helmet's viewfinder. Poor guy. He was our friend. And then you also realize that he's always had a key to tunnel number 21, which also makes us think that perhaps, and also because he has a similar journal that we have, perhaps he was on the same team that we were on, and maybe he kind of gave up on leaving this area and decided to just survive. This is the three. They are the new people that we trade with. And I think because of this part here where it's filled with an intense smell of mushrooms, I feel like maybe they were the ones who killed our friend. We are forced to trade with them now. So let's see what they have. We definitely need one of these, one of these, one of these. Okay. Actually, that knife is perfectly new, so let's keep it. And let's sell the ones that are kind of broken. So let's keep this knife here. So what did I put? Okay, I need nails, I need some boards. Sell the meat. So this knife, alright, so I'm just gonna do some housekeeping and I will see you guys in the next episode. So thank you for watching, bye bye.